Here's how to make super easy clear CDs. You want to grab your CD and make a cut with the silver side of the CD facing up. You want to take a piece of packaging tape and line it up with the cut you just made. You want to peel it back and it will end up removing that silver part of the CD. You want to keep using the packaging tape to remove the silver parts of the CD. By the end, all of the silver parts of the CD will come off, but you might have to use more than one piece of packaging tape. I made 7 CDs by now and I used mine to paint on them. This is one with lemons, but I also made one with strawberries, and I'm going to make ones with other fruits on them too.
I got tired of throwing out flowers. It feels like such a waste. Why do they even die? So I got a freaking huge jar. This one's from Target. I took the old flowers and separated the petals. Lots and lots of petals. Oven time. 180 degrees for like 10 minutes. Look at that spacing. Crunchy petals. Look at me go. So Pinterest. So artsy. Someone give me a trophy. IDK, I think it looks cool. Right. I can't wait to add yellow.
Testing viral DIYs that way you don't have to, part 3. Today I'm making one of those chunky knit blankets that you see all over Pinterest. To start, we're going to start by making a slip knot. So you're going to take your pieces, cross them over, and then pull the longer strand through. And then to make a chain, you're going to continue pulling the longer strand through, trying to keep your chains as even as possible. Then once you get to the end, you're going to take your last loop and turn it up, and then going through the next chain over, you're going to pull through the longer strand to make these little like bunny ears, and make sure you're keeping them about the same size. And then once you get to the end loop, you're just going to pull through that loop twice before beginning your next row, and then you're just going to repeat this process like a million times until you end up getting your blanket. I end up having 2 different colors, so I weave that in to make like a nice little pattern. And then once you get to the end, you're going to take 2 loops and pull the longer strand through to make another loop, and then take that loop, connect it to the next one over, and keep pulling through. If you're doing it right, you should start to see the chain start forming. Then just tuck in the little tail at the end and you're all done.
Let's paint Walmart shoes. After stalling for 15 minutes, finally buck. In starting. Like an orange, cold as balls. Anemic brown girls get cold too fast. Bad finish spray. The chemicals smelled really good, don't at me. Making shit waterproof, cause if he did all this work for rain to ruin it, I'd throw him. You done. $15 never looked so good.
I really wanted a custom neon sign, but I wasn't ready to pay hundreds of dollars for it, so I decided to make it myself. You need a stretched canvas, LED wire, and a hot glue gun. I started by writing my text on the canvas. I punched holes so that I can hide parts of the LED wire that I don't want to see. I'm using the hot glue gun to secure the wire on the surface. This whole project only took me an hour and 15 minutes. Don't forget to secure the back, and this is how it turned out.
I just came here to the party for the drugs. Drugs. I'm not trying to make a friend or fall in love. Love, love, love. So just stop the faking. Not here for nameless faces. Pointless talking conversation.
Hey semuanya, hari ini kita buat pembatas kuku vintage yuk. Pertama-tama siapin karton. Di sini aku bakal pakai karton duplex, tapi bisa banget pakai box bekas sereal. Kemudian untuk hiasannya sendiri, di sini aku bakal tempelin robekan kertas yang warna coklat dan juga denda kertas kayak gini. Berhubung hari ini temanya itu vintage, aku bakal pakai hiasan-hiasan yang warnanya coklat, putih ataupun hitam. Jadi kalau kalian kepengen tema vintage juga, aku saranin untuk pakai warna yang hitam, putih dan coklat. Di bagian atasnya aku hias pakai stiker bulan dan juga washi tape yang tulisan-tulisan. Karena di sini masih kosong, jadi aku tambahin beberapa gambar-gambar kecil pakai ballpoint warna emas. Dan terakhir, ambil pembolong kertas untuk buat bolongan di bagian atas. Terakhir, tinggal kalian masukin tali aja kayak gini. Aku pilih yang warna hitam, dan tujuan dikasih tali adalah supaya nanti kalau dipakai lebih gampang untuk cari halamannya. Udah jadi deh. Besok bikin apa lagi nih?
Lihat cara buat gantungan kunci yang super gampang. Pertama-tama, pilih gambar atau stiker yang mau kalian buat jadi gantungan kunci. Kemudian di sini aku pakai kertas kado dan aku tempelin stiker di atasnya. Selanjutnya, digunting sesuai bentuk stikernya. Setelah selesai, selanjutnya bisa siapkan plastik laminating seperti ini dan stikernya ditaruh di tengah-tengah plastik laminatingnya. Abis itu, bisa pakai catokan atau setrika dan laminating deh stikernya. Setelah selesai dilaminating, pakai pembolong kertas untuk bolongin bagian atasnya. Setelah itu, potong plastik laminatingnya sesuai bentuk stiker. Untuk gantungannya sendiri, di sini aku pakai ball chain, jadi aku masukin ke dalam lubang yang tadi dibolongin pakai pembolong kertas. Dan gantungan kuncinya udah jadi deh. Untuk tutorial DIY lainnya, bisa cek di channel YouTube aku ya. Bye-bye! Drops fall and the beauty of it all. When the sun comes shining through to make those rainbows in my mind. When I think of you sometime and I want to spend some time with you, just the two of us.